My name is Ivan. I'm co-founder at NewArc.ai. I'd like to walk you through the basics of writing prompts in NewArc.ai. There are two components in image generation, the prompt and the input image. Let me upload an input image and write a prompt. A green dress with yellow accents made of cotton, white background. Let's talk about how the image generation process works. AI doesn't know what you have in the input image. It's just a set of lines for the AI. Actually, the AI generates what you describe in the prompt, trying to fit it into the lines of the input image. So the first and foremost, AI relies on the prompt while using the input image as the guidance. So the right prompting is a very important part of getting the result you want. So here we have an example of a good prompt for the sketch. Let's break it down and see why it's good. First, it has the name of the product. Remember that the AI will generate what you describe in the prompt. If you don't name it, the AI will not know what to generate. Don't write something like, generate as similar to the original sketch as possible, or create 3D object from my sketch. You can see that there is no product name in these examples. The AI will have no idea what to generate, so it's not gonna work. Always name your product in the prompt. Second, the prompt has details of what you'd like to see in the generated images. A green dress with yellow accents, made of cotton, white background. We have color and we have material. The more explicitly you describe what you need, the better chance you have of getting the image you want. If you are listing several things in the prompt, you can use commas to separate them. Next, our prompt and input image are consistent with each other. Remember that the AI generates what you write in the prompt and fits it into the lines of the input image. If we have a front view of a dress in our sketch, we need to write in the prompt either a dress or a front view of a dress. If you write a back view of a dress, the AI will try to generate a back view of a dress and fit it into the lines of the input image, which is a front view of a dress. The result will be a complete mess. So your prompt and input image should be consistent with each other. Next, we have a negative prompt. This is where we specify what we don't want in the generated images. In our case, these are pockets and flowers. Don't put something that you don't want in the generated images in the prompt field, such as a green dress with yellow accents made of cotton, white background, no pockets, no flowers. Instead, put pockets, flowers in the negative prompt field. So if you don't want something in the generated images, simply put it in the negative prompt and separate multiple items with commas. Though, if you have something in the sketch, like buttons in our case, and you don't want to have buttons in the generated images, you need to remove these buttons from the sketch first, because every line from the sketch will appear in the generated images. And the last one, we described colors in the prompt. A green dress with yellow accents, white background. Our sketch doesn't contain colors, and the AI put those colors where it feels comfortable. If you'd like to have those colors in the specific places, you need to do the following things. First, you need to have them in your prompt. Then, you need to upload a sketch with the green and yellow colors. This way, AI will generate a green and yellow dress and will try to place the colors where they are present in the sketch. And you need to switch on the enhanced color guidance option. Otherwise, AI will ignore colors from your sketch. Now we can see that all the colors are in place. All right, let's briefly reiterate what we've just learned. Always specify the name of the product in the prompt. Describe details and separate them with commas. Provide consistent prompt and the input image. Put what you don't want in the negative prompt box. If you use enhanced color guidance, always describe colors in the prompt. So this is it. These simple rules will allow you to significantly improve the quality of the generated images. Happy creating!